Hey guys, today I'm showing you the Illustrator portion of how to make a 3D printed stamp. Okay guys, so first thing we're gonna do is we're gonna open up the Illustrator and we're gonna just start any old file here. Now, before we do that, I wanna show you what it is we're gonna be making. We're gonna be making a stamp that looks kinda like that. That says, you know, you always do your stamps backwards because when they're put onto the stamped onto the clay and pressed onto the clay, they will then be forward. So we're gonna make something like that. We'll do Perry family is what I have here. Maybe we'll do a different family. So first thing I do is open up Illustrator and I am gonna, you're not gonna need most of the properties like you normally would. We're just gonna draw an oval here and we are gonna do text on a path. So there's two ways to do this. You can either hover over it and hit the Alt Option key, or you can just go to Text, type on a path. I'm gonna type right here. I'm gonna type Perry Family. I'm gonna use a different font this time. So I'll make this font, how big do we want it? Maybe that big. I will adjust the width of these letters. Now I realize it's not centered yet. Also gonna pick out a different font maybe. That's kind of fun. That's too tight, I think. I like that. I mean, I've been using this American typewriter a lot. Okay, so we got our text on a path, but it's not in the right place. What I'm gonna do is come over here to the main black arrow, click on that, and you'll see these over here at the base of these two squares with lines going through it, that's the beginning and end point, as you can see. So the family doesn't go anymore. That's where my text ends, and this is where it begins. So I need to, I'll just hover over that thing until I get this black line with the arrow, and I'll move it to the center point. Now, sometimes it's hard to know the center point. So you can also go up here to View, Ruler, show your ruler, and then from the rulers, you can pull down guides. And guides help you get things just right. You know, maybe I won't like this guide. Right about there looks good to me. Okay, we got that. Now, okay, the next thing I'm gonna do is I'm gonna select this text. I'm gonna go to Object Expand. And what this does is it takes that text, and right now this text is still editable. I can change it. It could become the Perez family, but I can still change it. But what I'm about to do is go to Object Expand, and that will bust it up so that it's no longer text. Now it's a bunch of points. So you can see that. So you can actually, if you, like a lot of designers will take these and will make something really fun with it, you know, maybe that'll become like a happy face or something. Or maybe this is a bearded Perry. We're not gonna do that, but you can adjust those. But this is a vector, now just a vector path. So if we printed it like this, if we 3D printed it like this, when I stamped it onto the clay, it would actually be opposite. It would be in reverse. So I've done this 100 times, so I've done it once. Let's take this and let's go to Object, Transform, Reflect. And we're reflecting over the vertical. If we did it over the horizontal, it'd do that. But if you do it over the vertical, it does it backwards. Okay, so let's back up the tray and see what we got here. That looks pretty good to me. So now what I'm gonna do, now this is just something I like to do here, is I like to adjust the artboard. Artboard is basically like the size of your canvas. And when I import that into Fusion, if it's crazy big, it's oftentimes just a little bit harder. I don't wanna go too close to the sides of my text here, or I'll make more problems for myself later, but we'll do it about like that. And I'm just gonna go save, and we wanna save it as an SVG file. SVG right here. That's a vector graphic. Let me go Perry Family 2. Okay, save that, I'm gonna save it to the desktop, see if I got it there. And there it is, here's my Perry Family 2, SVG.